Welcome back, folks. Okay, folks, so what we're going to do here is that we're going to go through live how to fill out one of these SBA disaster assistance loans. Now, the bottom line, the first one that we're going to talk about, it is a loan advance, but the bottom line is that you can get up to $10,000, and it does not have to be paid back. So I'm going to start with this first page. This is going to be archived. It's going to be on the site. So if you know anyone that's in small business, tell them about it, okay? Because the bottom line, they can fill this thing out tonight, and you can see as we walk through this, the SBA is saying that this money is going to be in your account 3 days after this application is filled out. So first, I'm going to just bring you through how this baby works. So what this is all about, we know this is the $2.2 trillion package that went through Congress that got signed last week. This is the first one that came out that you can actually apply for. As these others come out, we're going to be all over it for you to make sure that we can walk you through the paperwork so that all your small businesses can sustain themselves on a cash flow. So what happens with this is you got an economic injury disaster loan assistance, okay? This is good for everyone in the whole country, every state, Washington, D.C., all of the above, okay? Now, I'm gonna jump right down to what we're going to talk about right now. The reason being is that they give you a $10,000 advance, and this is something that can help people pay their bills, pay their rent, pay everything, okay? The actual loans we talk about later actually go up to $2 million. So as we go down here, what you're going to see is this. The one I want you to take a look at first before we go through it, because I'm going to make this application live on the air. I'm just not going to hit the submit button because I already hit the submit button last night. Okay, so economic injury disaster loan advance. Okay, so you can see what it says. In response to the coronavirus pandemic, small business owners in all United States and Washington, D.C. and territories are eligible to apply for an economic injury disaster loan advance up to $10,000. It's up to $10,000. The advance will provide economic relief to businesses that are currently experiencing temporary loss of revenue. Funds will be made available within 3 days of a successful application. The loan advance will not have to be repaid. That's really important that everyone wrap their head around that, okay? Okay, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to go through it right now. I'm going to bring up the application. And as I bring up the application, where are you? Okay, so now, all of this is right on the front page of TFNN also, folks. So we have the application on there. We have how this works. So when you bring up the application, what this application is saying here is that the bottom line is that this is a self, basically, financial application. You're not going to have to send in your financials. You are going to have to give them your Social Security number, okay, but the bottom line is that just get it done, okay? So, eligible entity. So the first one here, this is a live application, by the way, folks. So choose one, applicant is a business with no more than 500 employees, okay? So I'm gonna check that because that's applicable. Then the next one that is on here, okay, applicant is not engaged in illegal activity as defined by federal guidelines, we check that, nope. No principal of applicant of 50% ownership interest or more than 60 days delinquent on child support obligations. We check that one. Applicant is not an agricultural enterprise. We check that one. Applicant does not present live performances of sex shows. We don't do that. Applicant does not derive more than one-third of his gross income from illegal gambling. Nope. Even though trading, can you imagine? That's legal gambling. Anyway, we don't. Applicant is not in the business of lobbying. We check that one. Applicant cannot be a state, local, or municipal government. Okay, so we check that one. So we got all this checked. This is how easy this is, too, by the way, folks, okay? We go continue. Okay, now legal business name, right? So legal business name we're going to put here, TFNN Corp. Okay. Trade name is the same, TFNN Corp. Okay, EIN number, let's see, where's my EIN? Okay, so 26399555556. Okay, type of organization, this is a S corp. Is the applicant a nonprofit? Nope. Is the applicant a franchise? Nope. Gross revenue. Okay, so now this is when we're walking through this. This is what you want to understand. So it says gross revenue for the 12 months prior to the date of disaster. I'm just going to say, okay, let's just say you can, well, you got to put your real number in here, folks, number one, okay? I'm just going to turn around and say, okay, let's say it's 300,000. I need another zero on that. No, I need another zero. Okay. So let's just say it's 300,000. Then the cost of goods, okay, so the way the cost of goods works, you do not put your payroll in the cost of goods. So whatever the cost of goods are, let's just say it's 100. I'm just putting these in here so you can get the gist of how this works. Okay. Then you're going to see that rental properties, none of these are applicable. Rental properties, residential, commercial, non-profit, they're not applicable to me. They may be applicable to you. Okay, so then we go all the way down. The next, when you see this little red mark, the next one would say primary business address. Okay, so it's 300 4th Ave South, and it's St. Petersburg, Florida. Florida, okay. And 33701. Business phone is 877-518-9190. Okay, business email is going to be OB1, let's see, at tfnn.com. Business establishment, that was what? Oh my God, it's so long ago. Okay, I'm going to 04 April 12th, 1994. Whoops. 04 12 1994. Okay, current ownership since 04. So what you do is this, folks, just whatever, if you forget the date that you started, just go to the filing, whatever state you're in, and it will have it right there. Business activity is where in the news business? I'll put educational. Detailed business activity. No, let's change this one. News, the news in here, media, let's see. Okay, I'll put finance. Detailed business activity, finance other. Number of employees, 10 employees. Okay, so you can see what's going on now. We're on the, what page? Okay, so that's business information, right? I'm gonna go to the next page. You just stay right there, folks. We got a quick break. We'll come right back. We'll finish this disaster loan assistance so you're gonna be able to do it as soon as the show is over. Come right back. Welcome back, folks. Okay, so folks, we're filling out this grant application. So next is the business owner information, okay? So bottom line is that first name, Tom, last name, O'Brien, mobile phone, 727-643. Whoops, what happened here? Okay, there we go. So title, let's see, it's the CEO at TFNN. Okay, in this case, it's 100% ownership. You go down to email. You want to put your email in again, ob1 at tfnn.com. Okay, so social security number. We'll see how this works. That's not my social, and that's not my phone number, by the way, folks, okay? I'm doing this. I'm not going to press the last button, okay? But I'm going to show you just how easy this. Bond, let's see. That this one's real. It's scary, man. Place of birth, Boston, beautiful Boston. U.S. citizen, yes. Residential address, okay, so you put your address down. Okay, so you're going to see, now we get the third page done right here, folks, okay? This is so cool, it's amazing, okay? So it's important to understand just how quick we've actually done this, okay? So we hit next. Oh, I must have something. Okay. See, this is the very top. Is your business owned by a business entity? So some businesses, so let's say that if TFNN was owned by another entity, which it can be, okay, then you would put the other entity in there. You say yes. In this case, it's no, okay? So it's no. If you say yes, this is what ends up happening. All that's going to happen is that another individual owner is going to come up and you fill that out, okay? So now we're ready to go to the next page. You go to the next page. We go to the next page. Okay, it says additional information. Now, last year, has the business listed been convicted of criminal offense? No. Is the applicant or any listed currently suspended or disbarred from contracting from a federal government? Nope. Are you presently subject to indictment? Nope. Okay. And then it has this space, if anyone assisting you completing the application. Well, no one did that. You're going to do it on your own. Okay, so now this is where it's cool, folks. It's this dramatic. You can see this number. I would like to be considered for advance up to $10,000. You click that. What we don't know right now, folks, is they don't have what the guidelines are as to, you know, how you're going to get the full 10 grand. Bottom line is that go do it, though, because you're going to get something. Well, it looks like you're going to get something. And right there, it says where to send the funds, okay? So the bottom line is that you're going to put your bank name down. You're going to put the account number. You're going to put the routing number. And then you're going to hit submit next. Now, oh yeah, then at the very end of this, you're going to read this disclosure. And the disclosure, folks, okay, is saying that you've told the truth the whole way. Now, it's something to keep your head wrapped around here. You can have a business without any employees and still apply for this. Because if you are 1099ing yourself, okay, the bottom line is that you can still do it. So don't worry about, I wouldn't worry about any of the numbers you're putting on this form as long as they are numbers that you are actually doing, meaning your gross revenue, the cost of your goods, the number of employees. Then under here, you're going to say, I hereby certify and pay the penalty of perjury under the laws of the United States that all the above is correct. You hit that, and then you are going to go next. Now, this won't let me go next because what's happening is that they want bank information, and I don't believe that the way this bank information works, folks, is that they're so attuned, they can actually find out, they can kind of have it that the, well, let me try it here, one second, hold on. Hey, let's see. So let me just, SunTrust. Well, this is pretty cool, okay? I'm just putting numbers in here, okay? And this thing turns green once it gets enough numbers. You see what happened? Okay, so I'm not going to submit this. So you put your bank name, you put your account number, you put your routing number, okay? Now watch this. We're going to go next. And what you're going to have here is it's going to give you a summary of everything you just did. Legal name, TFNN, TFNN Corp, my EIA number, type of company it is. It's not a nonprofit. It's not a franchise. Gross revenues. Cost of goods, you go all the way down, and what ends up happening, you're going to see this owner's information, and then they put, I am not a reboot. I am not a robot, a reboot. I am not a robot, okay? You're going to click that, and then you're going to hit submit. Now, I'm not going to hit submit. That's all there is to it, folks, okay? To turn around and what? You can get up to $10,000 for your business, and the basis of this, okay, is that you can keep a cash flow going, you can keep your employees going, And in some businesses, the bottom line is that that, you know, might be good for 2 or 3 weeks, a month. Other businesses, that could be good for a longer period of time.